Once upon a time, in the forgotten seaside town of Southfold, there was a crumbling old cottage, home to two old fuddy-duddy parents. And their super smart daughter, who had just been accepted into university. The problem? Well, they didn't want her to go. You see, that girl is me. And this, it's a letter, saying I'm running away. At least, I was, until this storm started. Now, I guess we're stuck here until the rain clears. So we may as well get to know each other. My name is Paige. 18 years old, astrophysicist in training. Hobbies include journaling, origami, oh, and bending the space-time continuum. But more on that later.
Yeah, the one that I'm not doing.
Finally, everyone's asleep. Now, where were we? Mom and Dad wanted me to stay in Southfold, to settle down here. But I always dreamt of bigger things, you know? Creating my own path. When I got the university offer, I thought it was finally my big break. But I wasn't allowed to go. They were worried it was too dangerous out there, in the real world. So, that's how I ended up here. A runaway. With a long journey ahead to the big city. I just hope that, when I graduate, they'll be there, you know? But for now, I've just got to focus on getting out of here. Is that Dad snoring in the other room? Well, that's my cue to leave.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Aaron. My name is Aaron. We're not really Aaron either.
We found a quiet corner of the cave and settled in for the night. My new friend promised to deliver my letter home, now that he knew the way back. As I lay by the fire, I fell into a deep sleep and dreamt of home. It was a cool winter morning, and the sun was rising over Southfold. Two twins had arrived earlier that night. A perfect girl called Paige, and a stinker called Oscar. They were inseparable. But I'll have to tell you more another time. It's already morning. We packed up our things and put out the last embers of the fire. After saying goodbye, I set off into the swamps alone. Hopefully there's no alligators.
말보다.
나한테 맡겨야지 배.
스파오 해와.
The pair led me to a large tree reaching out of the mangroves. As I climbed into the branches, they yelled that I'd forgotten something. I looked down at their grinning faces and was transported back. My brother Oscar and I played every day together. I'd make little paper animals, and he'd paint these amazing pictures. You'd see in his eyes, he'd get lost in his paintings. And then, one day, he just disappeared. It was like he slipped through the cracks of the world, right in front of me. Does that make sense? Anyway, sounds like another storm's rolling in. I read there should be a village north of these trees. If we hurry, we might be able to make it before sunrise.
Thank you.
Inside the nest, we nervously glanced around. Something didn't feel right. As we searched for the way down, a shadow crept over us. Before I knew what hit me, I was tumbling through the branches below. As I fell, the present gave way to the past. I remembered the first disappearance. Oscar had vanished. Everyone was worried sick. We searched the village high and low until finally, Dad found him playing with bullfrogs down by the water. How he got there? Nobody knew. Everyone was just pleased he was safe. For now. Several hours later, I finally came around. The rain had eased, and I could feel the warmth of the sun. A village was just up ahead, a sense of anticipation hanging in the air. Maybe there's a spare bed for the night.
What do you think I do? I really want to run these ones. I should have been there.
Men.
Oh,
imagination. And frontiers and of own.
As the villagers gathered round the fire to begin the festivities, the elder took me to one side. He leaned in and whispered. While trapped between, he'd seen unimaginable things. That I should be careful to prevent the same thing happening to me. The party carried on around me as I laid down to rest by the fire. Before long, the laughter of the villagers faded away. I awoke in a dream. Adrift in what felt like limbo. Is this what the elders spoke of? A familiar presence waited at the edge of the world and beckoned for me to follow. I awoke to the cool touch of raindrops on my face. It was morning. The whole village was awake. Had they even slept? They offered some frog tea, which I sipped reluctantly. With my mind still swimming from the night before, I bid them farewell. That wasn't quite the relaxing night's sleep I was hoping for.
Boop 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 boop. Thank you. Thank you. boop 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 boop.
An ancient door blocked our path forwards. With a low rumbling, the stone plates shook and then slowly parted. Peering into the small opening, a sense of claustrophobia took me back. After the incident, we were confined to the house. Mum and Dad were too worried for us to leave. As the hours dragged by, it felt like the walls were closing in around us. We stared longingly out the window. And I asked Oscar how he vanished. He said, if I promised not to tell, he'd show me. Our eyes adjusted to the darkness. Was this what she'd been searching for all these years? I offered to stay and help gather artifacts, but she insisted I carry on without her.
Ah, Thank you. Thank you.
I stepped over the broken glass towards the window. Those kids might be trouble, but they knew how to find a quick exit. Clambering through the makeshift opening, I said my farewells and began my climb down to the ocean below. Looking back at their faces, I could picture Oscar amongst them, as if nothing had happened. Growing up, though, it was just the two of us, so we had to make do with each other. He'd show me how to create these doorways, and together, we'd sneak away on adventures to far-off places. Mom and Dad never even knew we left our room. Once I'd gotten down to safe ground, I spotted a sailboat tied up nearby. With the city on the horizon, I sailed off across the ocean. Did you hear that? I could have sworn I heard someone calling for help.
Sinbimtim Wemtim. Wembuba Wanson. Sisi Wemwen. Me Sisi Wemwen. Sisi Wemwen. Shwil you bimkin. Bimtim Wentim. Try to know him. Shwil you bim him. Wembuba Wanson. Tinkin went it in, went it in bab. And tin twin went tin twin. I send wim bon at and whip wim. Tin bim tin went him. Swy and whimper. Then dim.
Stepping foot into the fishing village, the seafarer's wife came running. They hadn't seen each other in so long, but she'd never given up hope. They invited me in, and we shared stories over dinner. She told of her worry. That first night her husband didn't come home. And I spoke of Oscar, and the day he too disappeared. We'd taken one of our many trips far away, but Oscar wanted to go even further this time. Crossing the river, he lost his footing and slipped. Before I knew what happened, he was gone. And that was the last time I saw my brother. I like to think he's waiting for me. On the other side, you know? After talking long into the night, the tide lowered, and a path opened up across the sea to the city. I said my farewells and made the short walk across to the harbor. According to this map, the university is just ahead. We finally made it.
Thank you.
Minta.
After a long journey from Southfold to the big city, I'd finally made it to university. Just in time for my first day. Too tired to fully unpack, I lay on the bed to rest my eyes. Suddenly, my alarm woke me with a start. It was already morning, and lectures were starting any minute. I got up and rushed to class. The halls were full of new students, all nervously excited for their first day. The lecture hall was so big, and you'd never guess who my professor was. I got lost in my studies, and before I knew it, years had passed. Between assignments, I wrote home, but could tell my parents were still upset I'd left. And then, the big graduation day came. I'd passed with distinction. Diploma in hand, I looked out into the crowd, and I saw Mom and Dad. We talked for hours. They were sorry that they were so strict after Oscar disappeared, and sad I was going to live so far away. I told them I'm not as far away as they think. Quick fold in space and time, and I'd be home. They looked at me confused. I'll visit soon, I said.
I did not let my story fall. I hold you in my heart, and everyone I've met, I'll never forget.
Oh,